Yokozo, welcome back. Shining Pearl, episode six, maybe? I think it's six. Yeah. We are just about to take on Team Rocket. I mean, Team Galactic, because they're different. They are different. It's true.
Hanzai!
Unify and Dustox. Both. So, Leech Seed is a long-term version of, like, what Mega Drain does. I don't need this. It doesn't hurt to have them both. Realistically, you're probably not going to use both, but it could come in handy, right? And there's a good chance I'll be giving him False Swipe. I probably need to give it to a couple of people. Ho-ho!
Torterra!
Yes! 1,000 times yes. Earthquake is the best. You know what? I'm gonna get rid of this. There you go. This is what happens whenever leadership does not make clear their vision to the grunts. Because they're going to be all like, oh no, we can just take everything. And the leadership is like, no dude, we're trying to save the universe here. You can't just be going out and killing everybody or stealing stuff. What's wrong with you? I'm going to break into this place and kill a whole bunch of people. Wait, maybe not. You never know. Let's just see where it takes us, right? Hi, how's it going? Hey! We need that. Okay. Alright. Well, we got our fly. I suppose that's something. Whoops. Hold on. Mystery gift! I've been waiting for you. No, hold on. This is new. Manaphy egg? Really? Come on. Platinum style. Well, let's go, go check it out. I think I probably need to go to the clothes store to change my clothes. Does that make sense to anybody else? I just want to change my clothes. Platinum style. Oh. Hold on. Cool. Well, let's leave the hoodie on for a little while. Yes, okay. Thank you. And then... Yeah, look at that. That is gonna be cool. Alright, well, we'll have to, I want to hatch this guy first. And then we'll see. And I don't want to carry around two eggs at the same time. That might actually be a good thing for me to do. Kinda in the background. I'd like to get to the point where I don't, you know, I can just grind a few things, level up some guys, and get some monies, and, you know, it doesn't have to be in front of the whole world.
That kind of thing.
So, which way are we going? Lake Valor? We like Lake Valor. That's where we see the red Gyarados, among other things. That might be the only way to go at this point. Go. Yeah, no, that's the only way to go.
I guess technically we could fly. So, let's see, hold on. We're on 215. Trying to remember what that... Oh, we've already got that, but we can't use it yet. Okay.
It just ends. Okay, I guess this is where we're supposed to be going. So, let's go south. And Wembley's about to evolve. I keep forgetting that Tortuga is shorter, is smaller to level than the other two. 32 versus 36. So let's just keep Wembley up. Kid. I like how you can clearly identify most of these characters from the isometric view, or sorry, not the isometric view, from the overhead view. Oh, Ghastly, you're pretty all right. I don't have anything that's particularly terrible for you. Nope, there it goes. I guess it helps whenever you're almost 10 levels above your opponent. Yeah, man. Oh, that's gonna be so cool. I think that's another one that I've never messed with. They're giving you two super rares right out the gate? And it's early enough that you can do something with them. There are a lot of legendary type Pokemon in this generation. Usually you get the one, and then you get like maybe three-ish more. There's usually three or four normal type legendaries that you can get access to in a game. This one's got like 12. It just adds a bunch of cool little things that you can do end game or post game. Here's something that could be a lot more streamlined. I know this is how you used to do it, so I'm not gonna pretend that it has to be better, but it probably could be better. Omeg. It's an interesting word. Pomeg. For some reason I thought you could like start the sprinkle and then like shift your body over. So you didn't have to start over every time. That is not the case here, for sure. Whether or not that is something that I remember from the original game or not, I couldn't say. Ooh, a Crandallers. He found that here. This is a bad matchup. He's got Levitate. That's not gonna work. Okay. I was wondering, there was a little kind of blue Pokeball next to the a couple of my Pokemon, and I didn't know what it was, but that's a capsule. That's a capsule. For some reason, that's something that they need to show you. Ha! Sandstorm will do nothing. Also, I'm pretty sure you're about to die. Haha. Why would you want us to know that? Close combat's a good one. Quick attack, takedown. I think I'd rather have close combat than takedown. Actually, hold on. Just gonna say, we got close combat. Thank you. Hey, Graveler. Let's see if he's got sturdy. He does! Yes! Making catching all the easier. Graveler's name be today. I think I called him Bear. Volt Switch is an odd one. But it's actually pretty good. Special defense, I'm not actually gonna use that. Let's take off charge. It eats rocks. And Geodudes are rocks. So, you can see where we're going with this, right? B-E-R-N-D-T. That's an interesting word. Burnt. Hooray! I take on people that I know of. Your strategy has failed. Ah, poison point. I guess I'm in it now. Might as well keep going. You're not gonna die from poison. But I am gonna kill all these guys in one hit. Stomp. We'll take Stomp. The target is stomped with a big foot. It's like, come on. Where's that big foot coming from? Ponyta has these tiny little hooves. Now, Rapidash has got bigger hooves, but they're still not big feet. One of the best parts about having Fly is that there's a suspicious little hole in the fence, is that you can just go to the next area and then fly back and then, you know, heal your people up. But we're not exactly there yet. Isabelle, you're in charge. Oh yeah, Cyrus the Great. Cambyses. No, that's not even. Not even close. I'm pretty sure. Never mind. Just do a. The roads are closed because of electricity? Does that make sense to anyone? The trash can is empty. The trash can is empty! It's a weasel. No, it's a floatzel. TM92, aka Introduction? No. Yeah, Trick Room's kind of cool. There's not a ton of good reasons to use it, but it's definitely a strategy. Clefairy dancing under the moon. That's not what happens. You need rock climb for most of this. Bon appetit. Sure, why not? Oh good, it's two at a time. This will make things faster. I was worried I was gonna have to fight him piecemeal. Yeah, not great, but we can do this. Stop. Woot. That's right. That's it. I guess that's it. The kid looks so invested, and he doesn't have any Pokemon left. gentlemen and madame.
Ooh, Slowpoke.
Slowpoke and a Starly.
Hey, it's a Hoot Hoot.
We like Hoot Hoot.
Psychic flying. Actually, I think he's just flying.
No. I just got rid of Leech Seed.
That's a weird one.
Fake out. I hate you so much.
Yep.
Your title is Rich Boy. You can't. Come on. This is gonna be tricky.
Oops, no.
See what happens here.
Oh, I was worried about that.
Yeah, obviously, Minky is above the ground, kind of floating there. But because he doesn't have the ability levitate, he still gets hit by ground type moves. Which is kind of silly, but it is what it is. Still. It's good to know.
But yeah, Earthquake is just a beast. It is the one of the earliest super moves that you get access to
in a real way. You could buy the TMs to force it onto your guys, but in general, Earthquake's the first one that you're going to see. It's just overpowered like crazy. And there are so many things that are really affected by that ground move, and even if they're not that affected by it, you're still going to do a ton of damage. Highly recommend for any ground type. Really, almost any type that can use it. It's a pretty solid move. Aww. Wait, what? So they're siblings. I thought they were dating. And he didn't have poison point. Looks like no. That's good. Whoops. What just happened? Ah! I think because I had the healing move on first, it defaulted back to my own Pokemon to attack, which is dumb. But I wasn't paying attention, so it's my fault. Oh, cool, you can use Life Dew even after everybody's dead. Oh, he's got one more. Never mind. He's got two more. She's just hanging out. He's into it. Okay. I guess that's all that was. Dun, 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 dun. Yes, please. What? Come on. Seriously. Oh, okay, there you go.
So that's the blue shellos from the east side of the map. We already saw the pink one. There's the pink one. He's upset. That's not a good sign. How out of shape are you? The man likes the word fancy. What? Okay, cool. That's neat. You know, I think we skipped some stuff. Hold on. Can I do it from the town map? Actually, I can't go back. Can I not go back to that? Hold on. No? Oh. Well, then I better keep going. I'll backtrack. Once I get to the next city. Beauty Cindy. Is wearing heels at the beach. Why? Pshaw. That's, yeah, there's gonna be a decent bit of, backtracking. I think that's normal, though. From what I remember. There's a lot of random stuff you have to do end game, post game. Wingle's kind of a neat guy. You know what? I still don't have. Everybody's gonna kill him. Go. This will work. Everybody's gonna kill him. I can at least switch to someone who's not gonna die right away. Just start throwing Pokeballs at him over and over. Eventually, I will wear him down. I also have Ultra Balls I could be using, I guess. But, I hate to use Ultra Balls when I have Pokeballs. There we go. Look at that. What do you think they do with Pokeballs that break? I think I saw it once in the anime, and it, like, comes apart or something. But did they just throw it away? That can't be right. They're super into recycling and everything. I don't know.
And then you can't just stick them together. You have to buy a new one.
Why?
All right, Wingull. You get a very prestigious name, which I will come up with randomly here. You are a bird. Crumpet. Perfect. Probably not going to use you. Not going to lie. But still, you are welcome in the box. Iapa. Iapapa. Or Lapapa? It might be Lapapa. Although. Agave berries. Hey, we're here. It's so disappointing. All right, we're gonna fly. No, go back to here. We skipped a whole bunch of stuff for good reason, and now we can go back and do it again. And we've unlocked both sides of the road, so we don't have to worry about healing up and all that fun stuff. Oh, right. Hold on, I saw something. Let's go check out this cave real quick. I think this is that guy that's tunneling. Dig's a good one, too. Okay. I mean, I did, but I have to bring him one or something? Why would that be a type? Private investigator. That's my girl. Oh-ho! Ponyta versus Ponyta. Yeah. Careful about that. When curse is used by a ghost type, it does that. It'll take about half of your HP, and then it'll basically put this poison curse kind of thing until you switch them out. Then it's over. Comes with his own spoon. Oh no, my Swift is disabled. Pseudo-Wudo. Let's see if he has sturdy. Pokeball. Alright. Let's see. I'm gonna name you... Spruce. What a perfect name. Heart scales are, or at least they should be, I think, very important. They either let you learn a special move. There's a particular guy you go to, and he will teach your Pokemon a special move depending on what they are, what type they are. Girafarig! Ooh-hoo-hoo-hoo. Hello, Girafarig. I'm worried I'm gonna kill him. I need to put False Swipe on somebody. But who? I guess we'll see who can learn it first. That's so cool. Yes. Let's see. Speckle. Sure, why not? False swipe, nobody. I have no one that can use it. That's awful. Actually, we'll hold off. Ponyta. Lots of the Ponytas. The heck? Okay. Actually, it may have made more sense to go to the other one. Because I think we're done with that general section. I guess I want to take an unknown to that guy in the cave just to make sure he's not, you know, what he's asking for. But I got unless I need all of them? Ugh, okay. Whatever. Not interested. Go back and clean out this little area real quick. Hopefully real quick. It's a Buizel. I don't have a Buizel yet. I don't think I have a Buizel anyway. I do not. All right, Buizel, your name is going to be Stripey. Congratulations, Stripey. Fish. Magikarp. I think we can take him. I feel bad fighting Magikarps. It's like, it's not their fault that they're like that. A staring contest. Ultra intimidation. And then Gyarados faints. Remoray, that's a new one. I wonder how they justify the water Pokemon that are just kind of floating out in space, like Remoraid or Goldeen. I mean, Gyarados, you can see him all curled up like a snake or something like that on the land, but in, I think in the anime, like, Misty had a Goldeen, and it was basically useless outside of the water. they had to like toss it in a in like a fountain or something. Whatever water source was closest to be able to utilize it. That's why I didn't get a lot of screen time. But it's just an interesting little random thing that Pokemon allows. All right, let's go in here. See what this is all about. Welcome to the Great Marsh. Yes. 30 Safari Balls. Oh, cool. Whoops. Ah. It's like there's a funnel next to these doors. Oh. This is akin to the Safari Zone from the first game, where there's a whole bunch of random, kind of rarer types, and you can't battle them like normal. You have to basically just throw balls at them. There might be snacks and rocks involved, I don't remember, but it's certainly not a regular battle. I'm sensing a water theme. Obviously, we want to use Ponyta here. No, this is perfect for Clota. So Trooper's pretty solid, except he's a ground type now. So he's not gonna fare too terribly well. He will be able to attack. As long as he can attack first, there's a good chance he'll win everything. But if he has to... if he has to get hit, then there's gonna be problems. But really, this shouldn't be that big of a deal.
it's like, yep. That's the whole thing. What are you doing? You're fishing in a pool. There's no sport in that. Plus, I'm pretty sure there's no Pokemon in here. Barboach. Yeah, okay. That's the one I was worried about. Barboach is a water ground type. So we'll have to lean into our other moves. Not really a problem. There's a few of those out there. If we can see them coming, then Torterra is a pretty solid option. Never had a chance. How do you think they programmed this camera stuff? The idle camera? It's like, it's just so random.
Okay. Why? Why would you do that? It's good to see it. Substitute's a weird move. It's got some. It's got a benefit if you can build a strategy around it, but it's kind of annoying. Ooh, gravity. I don't know. That's a hard one to justify. I don't actually have any ground moves, and I don't really care that much. Shellos. What is he wearing on his face? I've always wondered this. It's just so strange. Because you assume the hair is his hair. It turns into his eyebrows, but that could happen, theoretically. But it looks like the blue piece is underneath the hair. What? What is going on? Does that help him move through the water? Quagsire. Quagsire, I believe, is a water ground type. It's the Wooper evolution. Yep. I can deal with Floatzeal. Yeah, look, it's underneath the hair. What the heck? Ice Fang, nice. Nice move. Okay, okay. You got me there. I'm 4 times weak to ice. 2 for each of my stats. Chloe doesn't have that problem. Although flinching is a problem. There it is. The Fen Badge. Yeah, Brian's a pretty solid move. Okay, we are done. We're gonna go heal and we'll save, and that's probably gonna be it for today. Made some good progress. I may do some... I wanna freaking hatch those eggs, but I don't wanna just run around for 20 minutes. Anyway, we'll figure it out. All right. Thanks for watching.